This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. We're going to be solving these two trig equations on this video. Find all angles in the interval 0 to 360 degrees, random to the nearest tenth of a degree, that satisfy these equations. So we have two separate problems, and let's look at the first one. Sine of x equals 3/7. You don't get a value of 3/7 from any of our special angles that are, you know, like 0, 30 degrees, 60 degrees, etc. So we're going to have to use a calculator. So make sure you get a scientific calculator so you can use the sine inverse function. But remember, what the sine inverse or the arcsine function gives you is an angle between negative 90 and 90 degrees. It doesn't give you all the possible angles, so we have to be very careful here. So we know that one solution, and it might not be between 0 and 360. Oh, by the way, put your, since we're doing it in degrees, use degree mode on your calculator. Okay, make sure you have it in degree mode. So what we could say is, let's do this. Is this going to be a solution? So you, in other words, you can find an angle. This isn't necessarily going to be the answer to the problem. So what we do is we do our calculator, and depending on how your calculator works, you have to know how to plug this in correctly. So we're going to do the inverse sine of 3/7, and let's see what that comes up to in a calculator. So I put it in there, sine inverse of 3/7, and rounded to the nearest tenth of a degree, I have 25.4. degrees. Okay, so notice that is in between 0 and 360, so that is going to be one of our solutions. Now, you have to pay attention to where that is. That's in quadrant 1. And then analyze how you could get the other place where the sine is going to be 3/7. There's two places in between 0 and 360 where the sine is positive, so there's two places where it's 3/7, and that would be in quadrant 1 and 2. So let's see. If you think about it, it's easier. So let's say it's, we know that one of the angles is right here. Let's say that's 25.4 degrees, right? So the other one is going to be over here, where this is also the 25.4, right? But what you're looking for is, right, here's one angle. The other one goes all the way over to here. So how would you figure out what angle that is? Well, if I go all the way to 180 degrees, I got to subtract that 25.4. So to find the other one, I could take my 180 degrees minus 25.4 degrees. Now, you could do that in your calculator, or you could write this as 179. Oops, sorry. I was thinking I had it in minutes, but I don't. So it's just 180 minus 25.4. What is that? Let's see, 6, 4, and 5, right? Okay, you could easily do this on your calculator, but this gives me another possibility. So now I've got the two angles, right, in degrees, rounded to the nearest tenth of a degree, that add up, I'm sorry, where the sine of x equals 3/7. So here's our solution to the first problem, 25.4 degrees and 154.6 degrees. The fact that they add up to 180 degrees has nothing to do with it. That's just because it happened to be the arc sine and it was in quadrant 1 and 2. But in general, our solutions aren't going to add up to 180 degrees, so be careful. The reason they added up is because I had to subtract this 25.4 degrees from 180. Okay, let's do the next problem, 4 minus sine of x equals 1. All right. Well, I haven't solved for the sine of x here, so we could do that in different ways. I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides, so that's negative sine of x equals 1 minus 4 is negative 3, And then if I divide both sides by negative 1, that tells me that the sine of x equals 3. But we know the sine is always, the sine of anything is in between negative 1 and 1. So right now you could say there's no solution. If you tried doing this in your calculator, x equals arcsine of 3, check it out and see what happens. Did you get an error message? You'll get an error message. It says domain error on my calculator because it's impossible to have an angle with a sine of positive 3. On the next video, we're going to do a problem. Let's say we tried a problem where you ended up with the sine of x equals, let's say, negative 3/7 instead of positive 3/7. And I'm not going to do the problem right now, but just check out this one little point. If I said x was the inverse sine of negative 3/7, and you put that into your calculator, you would get rounded to the nearest tenth of a degree, negative 25.4 degrees. Well, the problem is that's not in 0 to 360 degrees. So that's what I'm going to go over on the next video. What happens if you get something not in the range you're looking for? This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.